This is Streamline News for Friday, March 11, 2011, brought to you by SwimOutlet.com, the web's most popular swim shop. The British Nationals is drawing to a close, and a few great races unfolded yesterday. Fran Halsell had ankle surgery in December, and she said training hasn't been optimal. But that didn't keep her from taking part in a great battle in the final of the 100 free. Amy Smith turned 3/100 ahead of Halsell at the 50, and as you can see in this video provided by British Swimming, the two were stroke for stroke all the way to the finish. That's Halsell in the lower of the two yellow lanes with the black cap, and even with a compromised ankle, Halsell had the better kick that got her to the wall in 55.01 ahead of Smith's 55.04. Halsell's time is fast enough to put her on the World Championship team and give her the opportunity to turn her 2009 silver medal into gold in 2011. James Goddard won his second event of the meet and did so quite handily. He won the 200 backstroke in 157.08, more than 4 seconds ahead of the competition. The time is now the fastest in the world, though just a little bit faster than the 157s Tyler Clary and Ryan Lochte posted at the Grand Prix meets. Michael Jamieson, the winner of the 100 breast in Manchester this week, also won the 200 breast and will now swim both events at Worlds. Jamieson's time of 2:10.42 is the second fastest of the year, behind a 2:10.28 by Japan's Yuta Suinaga. Andrew Willis touched second in 2:11.13, also fast enough to qualify for World Championships. Rebecca Adlington will lead the field in today's 800 freestyle final. After her 4:02 in the 400 free earlier in the meet, everyone is anxious to see what the Olympic champion and world record holder will post in this event. Also racing in the 800 is 1500 champ Carrie-Anne Payne, open water Olympic medalist Cassandra Patton, and 200 free silver medalist Jazz Carlin. Adam Brown and Simon Burnett, both of whom train in the United States, are the top two seeds in the 50 freestyle final. Brown just missed out on the qualifying time needed to earn a spot on the world team in the 100 free, and Burnett will also be looking for an individual spot on the team. The women's 200 back will be another great event to watch. Three of the top five seeds, Stephanie Proud, Elizabeth Simmons, and Gemma Spofforth, were ranked in the top 15 in the world last year. Simmons and Spofforth went 1-2 in the 200 back at last summer's European Championships. Look for a recap from the penultimate night of swimming in Manchester on swimmingworld.com, and be sure to check back Saturday as well for the final night of action. Drury seems to have no equal in the Division II Men's and Women's Swimming and Diving Championships. After 2 days of competition, the lead on the men's side has grown to a staggering 143 points, while the women have a 91-point lead. A few Division II records were broken, with the highlight coming from Casey Hurl-Zeidelman of Incarnate Word in the women's 400 IM. Hurl-Zeidelman, who formerly swam for Texas A&M, swam a 4:14 flat in the 400 IM, breaking the record of 4:15.76. You can read about the other records set and top finishers on our college channel at swimmingworld.com. If you're planning to attend the London Olympics as a spectator, get your credit cards ready to buy tickets, which go on sale this Tuesday. Almost 60,000 tickets will be made available at cosport.com through April 22nd. Now, why are tickets going on sale March 15th? Well, it's 500 days from the opening ceremony. That's going to do it for this edition of Streamline News. We'll see you back here on Monday.